And welcome to my channel. Today I am starting a new vlog, which you can probably tell by the title of the video. It's the 9th, yeah, the 9th of November today. Monday afternoon I actually filmed a makeup tutorial. As you can tell, I don't regularly do looks like this just for fun, because it's, well, for fun, yes, but not for daily life, because this takes about an hour. Anyway, but yeah, I thought I'd just start a new vlog now, because why not? I really don't know what I'm going to do the upcoming 3 weeks. I hope that in a week and a half I'll be able to like go to the cinema again if they open again. But other than that, I don't really have very distinct plans. I'm just going to take you along on the next 3 weeks as usual. And hope that along the way I'll find something fun to talk about. But yeah, for now I'll see you in the next clip. And today is Friday morning. Just thought I'd do a quick update while I do my skincare. Yes, even in winter I wear SPF. I don't know, like I work outside and I'm kind of paranoid about skin damage. But yeah, about the job opportunity thing, like the job application I filled in. I sort of have an update and sort of not. Like basically it's been a week and I didn't get any response, so I figured, I'm probably just gonna get ignored like usual. But I checked the website and now it says... Wait, can't talk while I'm rubbing skincare into my neck. Anyway, we're good. But basically, I just checked the website and now it says candidates rebooked. Basically, but then in Dutch, obviously. Which tells me absolutely nothing. Like, first it was like new applicants and now it's candidates rebooked. So I'm not sure if that's like a good thing or a bad thing. I have no idea. And like, at least like with like... I don't know, like government websites, like taxes and stuff, when they like say something like that, like when they use like work lingo, there's like this nice little question mark next to it, which you can click on and then it explains what exactly it means. Yeah, okay, this website doesn't have that. So I have absolutely no idea, like I have new information now, but I have no idea what it means. Like, I have no idea if it's a good sign or a bad sign. I have no idea if that's, like, the next step to being rejected. Or whether or not I actually make a chance of getting the job or whatever. It tells me absolutely nothing. And it's, like, it's kind of annoying. Because, like, really, I want the job. So, yeah. So, yeah, that's mildly frustrating. Also, in other news, I realized that it's actually, well, not almost Christmas. But I was like, there's a lot of people already posting like about their Christmas trees on Instagram. So then I finally checked the... I gotta wait for this to sink in before I can start doing my makeup. Oh, I might do my hair in the meantime. Anyway, but yeah, like basically I saw a lot of people posting about their Christmas trees. And I was like, but it's only... Oh, wait, what date is it? It's halfway through November. Which, you know... Yeah, made me realize that I have exactly one normal video left to film, makeup tutorial left to film. And then I really should start get going on the holiday looks. So yeah, luckily I realized, thanks to people on Instagram and their Christmas trees, realized that on time, because Christmas, well, you know, the entire... basically the month of December is spread out in a way that gives me 10 uploading days for makeup tutorials. So my idea is to do 6 winter and just basic festive looks for any occasion. Then in the week of Christmas I want to do 2 typical Christmas looks, in the sense of looks that are, you know, really Christmas. So like, you know, red and green, like looks that scream Christmas to me. I'll move the mirror a little bit. I'm trying to not have the logo on my shirt showing all the time. anyways, but yeah, because my work shirt. But anyway, and I want to do in the week of New Year's, I want to do really sparkly New Year's looks. So that's basically the plan. I might toss in some body paints and stuff, I'll see. But yeah, that's basically the plan. But obviously I do need to start filming those at some point in time, so good thing I realized in time. But yeah, so because like, I don't know, like this year, like other years, of course, you can go more places and... You know, I go shopping a lot normally. And then you just see all the wintry things and the Christmas things and all the festive things in stores. And it really feels a lot more like Christmas. And this here is more like, you know, you really gotta pay attention to it yourself because it doesn't get shoved in your face. And I actually prefer when it just gets shoved in my face that it's almost Christmas. Because otherwise I just plain forget. I'm like that. So yeah. I really don't like, and here in the Netherlands, normally everyone can light fireworks. Which to me personally always seemed a bit odd that just everyone can play with explosives, basically. Doesn't seem very good for the environment either. This year, however, it's probably not going to be allowed just because of, you know, because of COVID, there's already a lot of pressure on people who work in like hospitals and stuff. And each and every year there's a lot of accidents with fireworks, so they want to prevent it this year by just banning it this year. Honestly, I'm not bummed about it at all because I don't like sudden loud noises. I love loud music, but I don't like sudden loud noises. Just using a boar bristle brush, by the way. I feel like it's just nice for my skin. Anyway. And yeah, so basically, and because I work as a postman, you know, like, I normally don't listen to music very loudly at work because I just find it very rude if someone is like asking me something about a mail and I literally can't hear it. I can't hear them. But you know, like on basically if I have to work on the 31st of December, I do listen to music loudly and I wear earplugs. Basically, I wear earplugs and headphones on top of it because I don't like sudden loud noises. Which is just annoying for everyone, especially me. So yeah, I'm not gonna miss the fireworks at all. However, I do understand that for people for who it's like very beloved tradition, you know, that it is, you know, one amongst many, many things that just can't happen this year, and that sucks for those people. I mean, I do understand that. Like, for me personally, I'm happy about it, quite frankly, but I do understand that for other people it really sucks. But yeah, like, I don't know, like, any and all, loose hairs. But yeah, like any and all festivities and all and occasions this year needed to be celebrated differently anyways. So I feel like it's, you know, like, of course, you know, it's different than other years. Like if you're used to like celebrating Christmas with a lot of family or like me and my parents usually go to a hotel. Yes, it's different this year. But on the other hand, you can still celebrate. You just got to celebrate differently. Like, this is the situation we're in, and we're just gonna have to deal with it, so might as well try to at least make the best of it that you possibly can. You know, that's basically how I try to look at it. So, yeah, like, really, we're just gonna make the holidays as much fun as possible, and I'll try to make them fun on my YouTube channel as well. You know, that's, well, I know I'm gonna have fun, like, I have a lot of fun plans with the makeup. So, yeah, that was basically my little update for today. I'll speak to you again later. And we're back for another quick update. I really need to go start filming in different parts of the house just to get different backgrounds, don't I? Anyway, but yeah, I just got called back about the job opportunity thing. It turns out you gotta have a contract of at least 25 hours already in order to be allowed to do that. Like, to be allowed that opportunity. And as a mailman, you can't get more than a 20, like, at least, well, officially, you can't even get more than a 15-hour contract these days. I got lucky with a 20-hour contract, but I sure as heck can't get a 25-hour contract as a postman because there's just not that much work. And, you know, they just don't give that big a contract. So, yeah, apparently that is not an option. I find it quite, I don't know, like, yeah, annoying rules because literally that way you just can't get further as a mailman. From that point, but anyway, but the guy who called me back did actually give me advice to immediately contact transport, like the division of transport of the company. So I did that. I just emailed them and hopefully they can point me in the right direction. And if that also doesn't work out, I'm just going to have to search outside of PostNL. Simply because literally, like, on a 20-hour contract, I'll never get out of my parents' attic. And that's just getting kind of annoying. So yeah, it's still an ongoing process. Okay, I have a movie review for you, even though the cinemas will only open next Wednesday again. But I bought a DVD. Also, by the way, in case you're wondering what this is supposed to be, it's a body paint. I actually filmed a makeup tutorial today. It's going to be online in the first week of December. Specifically, the first Thursday of December is going to be this video. But yeah, anyway, today is only the 15th of November, actually, but I worked ahead, and so I already am filming for the holiday season now, which I absolutely love. But anyway, the movie I wanted to review is Kiss Kiss Bang Bang. I totally bought it just because it has Robert Downey Jr. in it. Now I still haven't gotten over the whole thing that I had as a teenager of like watching movies simply because I like the main actor. But yeah, it's a fun movie. Like, some of the humor isn't exactly politically correct anymore, and there's some very dark humor in it. But I think it's quite funny. Also, it's 15 years old. So I don't think I'm gonna spoil anything if I tell you that it does actually end well. It's a lot of fun. Actually, you could... It just occurred to me that you could know from the beginning that it ends well because it's literally the main character telling the story, like, far afterwards. So obviously he survives, otherwise he wouldn't be telling the story. That didn't occur to me until just now. Anyway, it's funny. Robert Downey Jr. looks really hot in it, which is always a plus. So I like it. And also the DVD was kind of cheap. Because again, old movie. So yeah, that was just a little movie review, just in case otherwise people would start to miss them. And ordered some food at La Pascala today. I can't remember what it was called, and it's on the ticket with the number 55, so that's not telling me much either. But it's like a pasta dough with spinach and cheese. And we're on the way back from the dentist. No, I'm not driving, otherwise I wouldn't be like filming with my camera in my hands like this. But anyway, my teeth are all fine. It was just a regular checkup, and yeah, no cavities, and they're nice and clean again. Yeah, this afternoon I'm also going to go to the cinema again, so we'll see another movie review. So I'll talk to you later. By the way, the dentist also said that I upkept my teeth very well. So that's always nice to hear. I brush them twice per day with an electric toothbrush, mostly to keep them nice and bright. But, you know, they also stay healthy that way, so that's good. I'm just gonna quickly fix my nails up as well, by the way. Like, these still look kind of decent. These look mildly dreadful at this point. Right hand, of course, dominant hand, you know. But yeah, I am still going to keep them short because we're still on project find a full-time job. But I am going to make them square, I think, and just make them a little bit more sparkly, I guess. So yeah, I'll show them to you once they're done.
And nails are done. Like I said, they're still quite short and natural, but glittery as well.
Okay, I'm back. I've switched a very bright light on, so I'm blinded, but at least you can see me properly. Whether or not that's a good thing at the end of the day, when I'm like oily as hell. Well, that's for you to decide. But anyway, I just got back from the cinema. It was really, 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 really fun. Like, the movie is awesome. Basically, it's a movie freaky, and I actually wanted to see it. I probably would watch it anyway, because like, I love any sort of horror movies, really. But I saw Made You Look, like Lex from the channel Made You Look by Lex, Made You Look on YouTube. Look her up, she does really cool tutorials. But I saw her do a look of like Millie, like the girl from the movie, when she is like, when the serial killer has her body. This is gonna make more sense when I explain something about the movie. But anyway, she did a body paint of that, and you know, with music and stuff and all, and it's usually stuff she mentions that she likes, I like as well. So I figured if she likes the movie, then chances are I'm probably gonna like it too. So I went and saw it, and it's really, 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 really cool. Like, it's a slasher movie with a twist, you know? Like, a slasher movie, like Friday the 13th, like Halloween, like Friday the 13th, I already mentioned that. Nightmare on Elm Street, you know, Knives Out, and just, you know, a brainless slasher movie. In a way, but with a twist, you know? Like, it's different, like, it's original. It's not just the same thing as they have been doing from the 80s onwards. No, in this case, like at the first house where you see people getting murdered, teens getting murdered, of course, there's always teens. The serial killer steals a knife, which happens to be, he didn't know that obviously, but it happens to be a cursed Aztec knife. That was originally used for sacrifices and stuff like that, you know, bad things. And yeah, then the girl gets stabbed by him. And then they trade bodies. Not voluntarily, of course. So, from that point onwards, there is this cute, sweet, usually nice, you know, normal teenage girl who is actually, you know, currently, like, possessed by a serial killer, like a grown man, like, middle-aged, with a bit of a violence fetish. And on the other hand, you know, the actual teenage girl wakes up in the body of a tall, grown-up serial killer man. Which, you know, and also, you know, like, the police knows what he looks like at that point. Like, there's composition drawings all over the televisions. So you don't really want to be stuck in the body of a serial killer who is currently being searched for. Because it doesn't make you very popular. So from that point onwards, she has to, like, convince her friends that she is actually herself, even though she looks like, you know, the male grown-up serial killer. And they, like, have to make sure, like, they have to make sure that she gets her body back, you know, that the switch gets undone. And it's just a lot of fun. Like, without spoiling anything, the movie has just a whole, like, brainless slasher thing to it. But it also has a lot of humor. Like, seriously, there's a grown-up guy acting like a teenage girl. Like, seriously, like, you know, seriously, I don't even know what the actor's name is, actually. Like, I didn't look it up. But he is really, really good because he is convincing. Like, you actually believe that he is, in spirit, a teenage girl. Which, for a grown man, is quite an accomplishment. So, yeah, it's really, really cool. It's really funny. It's hilarious. The actors are really good. It's really entertaining. It also has its more, like, emotional parts. Nothing too much for the type of movie it is. But it is a really, really cool movie. I really liked it. I'm definitely going to buy it on DVD when it comes out on DVD. I hope it comes out on DVD at some point in time. Most movies do. If by the time you see this vlog is not in the cinemas anymore, or if you can't go to the cinema in the country you're in, definitely try to look it up on some kind of streaming service or whatever, because it's really worth watching. It's a lot of fun. So yeah, that was my movie review. Yeah, we have 1 week of vlogging to go from this point, by the way. I have no idea if I'm going to be doing anything else interesting. Probably not. I'm mostly going to work. But nevertheless, I'll see you again in the next clip. And today is Saturday the 28th. I thought I'd just give you a little update on project Find a Full-Time Job. It's been 2 weeks, week and a half, at least a week and a half since I sent that other letter to that other thing, that other part, like the old truck driving thing. And I've gotten absolutely no reply at all whatsoever, so I'm assuming they're just ignoring me, because that's what usually happens when I try to apply for a job. I get ignored. It's not very motivating, but it's what happens. So yeah, plan B is now to go look for something else entirely. Or to look for something, you know, well, actually just simultaneously try for both. And hopefully find something that's like next, that I can do next to my work as a postman. So something really early in the morning maybe, so that I can at least, even with two jobs, just get, you know, two jobs combined full-time hours, basically. So that's the new plan. Also, I'm going ice skating on Monday, so I've dug up my old, well, I'm not even sure if those are mine or my dad's or whatever, but they're ice hockey skates. Because the ice skating rink is open again, and obviously they can't have as many people on there as usual, so there's less people there now to see it when you fall on your face, inevitably. Which is good. But last time I went, I wore ice dancing skates, which are really pretty, but they also have these sort of brakes on the front. So that if you lean forward too much, then you just stand still with one foot and trip yourself over, which is not good. So I figured I'd just wear the ice skating, like the ice hockey things this time. I still want to go with a friend at some point in time, but I thought I'd just go check how it is now, because, you know, obviously the kiosk is like all... Obviously, well, in the Netherlands, all the, like, restaurants and stuff need to be closed. Including everywhere that sells, you know, food where you can actually go sit and eat it. Like, takeaway is fine, but, like, at the ice skating rink, the little kiosk can't be open. So it's literally just an hour of continuous skating. So, yeah, I just want to check it out myself first on my own to see if it's fun. So that's the plan. I don't think I'll vlog there. But I might vlog with my phone. I'll see if I dare to. I'll see if I have enough balance really to hold my phone and not immediately sit on my behind on the ice. But yeah, we'll see. Also, if you don't forget, I'll vlog again later today to show you a makeup palette that I bought, because I also bought the newest Jeffree Star Cosmetics palette, and it's supposed to arrive today, so that's pretty exciting. So yeah, talk to you again
oh,
later.
Oh, and another order also arrived. We ordered wine again. I always order the Dornfelder. This is our favorite wine maker. But yeah, I always order the Dornfelder and the Clover Noctash. And seriously, this one is like, it just reminds me of vacation in Germany. And this time I also ordered this one because it's alcohol-free. I'm kind of curious. It sounded nice, so I decided to try it out. Okay, the alcohol-free one actually looks really, really cool.
And it's still the same Saturday, but now it's evening and I got the Blood Money Palette by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. You can think of him what you want, but I do actually really like his makeup quality and that's what really matters to me. So I ordered it because I also have the other ones and when I start collecting something, like makeup palettes, I want them all. But yeah, it looks pretty cool. And then there's this little lock mechanism and then there's a mirror. I was gonna say I'll try not to blind you and then I aimed directly at the lamp because I'm smart and I looked into it and now I can't see anything. I don't make smart choices, but anyways, this is what it looks like, really, really pretty colors. I think I'm actually going to use this for a Christmas holiday season tutorial as well because of the greens and the golds. I think it's pretty suitable for that too and also with red lips maybe. I want to do a more higher end look, higher end, because I'm not rich enough to buy a bunch of Dior palettes. But you know, more expensive makeup and also a budget proof one. But anyway, that doesn't matter right now. I like the colors, I like the mirror. Yeah, I think the color scheme is pretty good. This here was a swatch of the green shade Emerald Estate. And let me just swatch another one, Divine Intervention. Wow! It looks pink in a pan, but then it reflects green, which is pretty cool. One of the little foots here is loose. I don't know, it's not glued on properly, but I can fix that. In fact, it's my own fault because I opened it downstairs and carried it up the stairs and slammed it against the side of the stairs because I'm not clumsy at all. Where'd you get that idea? But anyway, I'm definitely going to have fun with this and you, if you want to see it at least, will be able to see a tutorial with it sometime soon. And I indeed went ice skating, but I didn't vlog with my phone because my skill level is not to the same point with ice skating as it is with regular skating, so I didn't dare myself to hold my phone while ice skating. I don't think it would have ended well. You're also obligated to wear gloves on the ice. And I figured if I wear gloves and then hold my phone, I'm gonna drop my phone, skate over it, and then I'm gonna have to buy a new phone, which would not be good. So let's not risk it. And I went there on my own, of course, so yeah, there was no one else to film me either. But anyway, yeah, like I just dried my ice skates off here. They're really, really cheap by Nydam. I don't know the brands, but I can already see after one good time of use that they're sort of going a bit, well, not really blunt yet, but they're wearing down already. I don't know, they're probably really cheap, but they work well, and for occasional skating is fine. I do think I'm going to go an hour later next time, because, you know, then it's a lot less busy on the road, and I might not actually take a wrong turn 5 times. I was on time. But I was only on time because I gave myself 15 minutes extra, because I know myself. So yeah, I drove the wrong way like 50,000 times. But still, I got there well, I went ice skating, and now I know that I can actually ice skate. Like, I don't know, like it was just a lot of fun. Like at first I had to like learn how to trust the ice, if you get what I mean. But by the end, I was just skating and having fun and actually passing other people by every now and then when they were not going very fast, admittedly, but still. Like, I could make turns and yeah, like, I'm happy. So I'm definitely gonna go there again. But yeah, I think I'm going to go to a gardening store this morning as well because I want to see if they have, like, big ponchos and stuff because it's a gardening store that has that sort of stuff. If so, I'll show you later, and otherwise I'll just end the vlog somewhere today too, because we've already done 3 weeks of vlogging. So yeah, talk to you again later. And I'm back. I also bought a bunch of like socks because they were on sale, so I've now 9 pairs of thermal socks. But that's not really interesting, so I'll just not show all the boring stuff. But one of the more interesting things I bought is a scarf. I clasped it together here with the little thing that came with it. And it's shorter than my other scarf. I thought it was longer actually, but oh well. Wow, and then one of the lights goes out. I switched on the lights because it's really dreary weather, so otherwise it would be kind of difficult to see. But yeah, it's a really cute scarf. You can just toss it over like this and sort of wear it as a coat. Yeah, it's not actually that short. It's nice. It's a nice color and it's nice and warm, which is good. I'll just take it off now because it's really messing up the light balance of my camera otherwise. And otherwise I look like a full-on ghost. I also bought... I don't even know what these are called in... I used to know what these were called in English. We call them Christmas stars in Netherlands. They had a pretty name too in English. I really can't remember. I can't remember. It doesn't matter. Anyway, but these have yellow flecks on them. I just thought it looked really cute. The pot we already had. Maybe it's Intratuin too. I'm not sure, but like this thing was really cheap and it's really adorable. So it's going to live on my desk for as long as it's... For as long as it's alive. Yep. And lastly of the interesting stuff, I bought a little lantern. Like, I've been wanting something like this for a very long time, but it's usually you only see those really big ones and they're like over 100 euros and it's really expensive. But this one was only like 13 euros. And look, it blows the glitter around. It also, it gives off light, but you can't really tell because it's now very light here. But yeah, there's a little snowman and a Christmas tree and it just looks so cute. And yeah, I really like it. It is real glass, so I'm going to have to be careful with this. I'm not sure where I'm going to put it. It just runs on batteries, by the way. But yeah, it's really pretty. So that's a mini shopping haul. I'm also going to end the vlog here because, like I said earlier, we are at the 3-week mark. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. If you want to see more of my videos, I mostly do makeup tutorials, you can always subscribe to my channel. And, you know, you can also do that if you just want to not miss my next vlog in another 3 weeks. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!